Each new star, information is power. Be current, the news headline. Umar Islam's IPOP for kicking against Buhari visits to Ebonyi. The news in full. The governor of Ebonyi State, David Umahi, on Sunday berated the leadership of the outlawed indigenous people of Biafra, IPOP, for kicking against the proposed visit of President Muhammadu Buhari to Ebonyi State. The governor expressed his dissatisfaction with the group while addressing politicians at the end of the year, Thanksgiving service of the state at the new government house, Tabu, Centenary City, Ebonyi State. Reports had claimed that President Muhammadu Buhari would visit Ebonyi State in November to commission some projects, but that visit didn't hold. Umahi, however, revealed that he will meet with Mr. President alongside prominent leaders of the Southeast to discuss the issue of peace in the zone. According to him, I saw where one misguided element that calls himself IPOP said Mr. President is not welcomed in Ebonyi. He is inconsequential and I want you to put it on social media that he is so inconsequential. I was in Paris when I told Mr. President that the leaders of Southeast would want to visit him over the issue of peace in the region and appeal to him to postpone the visit to next year. But I didn't want to tell our people because I was urging them to keep pushing our project as if the president was going to come this year. And I'm not sure up to three or four people knew this, so I kept it to myself. So, Mr. President will come when we want him to come. That IPOP guy is an inconsequential human being. If he is serious, let him hit the wall and come to Ebonyi State and let him see if he would find fit to go back. Somebody will sit somewhere and be talking rubbish and they will be misleading our children to go and be killed. But himself will not be at the war front. Any of them that will talk rubbish about security in the Southeast should come and lead the war. And I will also lead the war from Ebonyi State. And like David, we will always kill Goliath. When they talk rubbish, just ignore them. This land belongs to God, he stated. And this was after the IPOP had actually said that President Muhammadu Buhari's visit was not welcomed in Ebonyi State. So, the organization noted that IPOP, like other groups, is entitled to its views. Uwanize said it has been lobbying other regions to support the Southeast geopolitical zone to produce the next president. They agreed with the Arewa Consultative Forum, ACF, on the need to lobby other regions, and the chairman of the ACF, Chief Audu Ogbe, on Thursday said that the Southeast must get the support of other regions to enable the zone to produce the next president. Responding, Uwanize spokesman Alex Ogbonaya told The Nation that the idea of going around and lobbying other regions for support for the president from the Southeast region is good. There is nothing wrong with it. Chief Ogbe also knows that the President General of Uwanize Indigbo, which is Professor George Obiozo, has spoken to him about the need for the president to come from the Southeast geopolitical zone. We have also met the people of the South-South and people of the Southwest, so we are moving about. Ogbonaya called on Nigerians to support someone from the Southeast for president in 2023, saying that they want to use the opportunity to remind the ACF that in 1959, the Igbo through Dr. Nnamdi Azikiwe supported the North. 20 years after, in 1979, the Igbo through Alex Ekwueme, Keo Mbadiwe and others also supported the North, which saw the emergence of Alhaji Shehu Shagari as the president. Another 20 years after, the Igbo supported President Olusegun Obasanjo, and thereafter we supported Gerard Wa and later Dr. Jonathan. We have always been supporting others. Our simple prayer is for Nigerians to do unto Igbo what we have been doing unto others, he said. And on the misconception that IPOP represents Indigbo, Ogbonaya said that the other thing which they also said is that the IPOP is causing embarrassment and horror. In response, it is strange and curious that some Nigerians would highlight the views expressed by the indigenous people of Biafra IPOP and not the ones expressed by Uwanize Indigbo. IPOP is an organization. We have many organizations in Igbo land, saying that Nigerians should rather take the views of Uwanize as representing the entire Igbo people, and says The Nation captured the response,
through the ACF chief, Aldo Ogbe, and also that of the spokesperson to the Uwanizi Indibo via the chairman, who happens to, you know, make it clean and clear that the IPOB does not represent the Southeast Uwanizi Indibo.
Justice Peter Inyako, on November 10, 2021, Mazen Abdikanu was extradited from Kenya back to Nigeria, of which there has been a case where the lawyers have said that this was an unlawful means of bringing him back to Nigeria after it was reported that he jumped bail in 2017, where it was allegedly said that the military invaded his house and killed several people, in which his parents who actually lost their lives. And ever since then, this case, ever since he has been extradited back to Nigeria, this case had been, had been at the Federal High Court, Abuja, where 7-count charges were made against Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. And here is the vice president saying that for peace to reign, it is necessary for these self-determination agitators to stop doing things that would separate Nigeria, because our unity can never be divided
based on instinct. Yet, there are certain things that could be done by virtues of words. It is a known fact that inspirations toward actions could be triggered via words. This speculation has led to the subject of this article, which features to present a throwback of Obasanjo's word in 2017 that could be an inspiration for him to meet and educate present-day separatists. Sometime in the year 2017, former President Olusegun Obasanjo had an interview with Newsweek magazine, and in the course of the interview, he made heartwarming statements regarding the Biafra war in relation to Nnamdi Kanu's agitation at that time. In the same vein, he expressed his unquenchable desire to meet with Kanu's alongside with other separatists across the country in order to admonish them on the need to keep secession by the side and embrace unity in the country. In the light of this throwback, here are the words of Obasanjo that could inspire him to meet separatists of today and teach them to embrace unity. Obasanjo highlights on civil war. Those who fought in the war in Biafra will not want to fight in any other war. I fought in that war, and it was an unfortunate war. I said I had fought one war too many in Nigeria. I don't want to see another, he said. This is indeed a motivating statement that could inspire Obasanjo as a patriotic leader to meet Kanu and other separatists, informing them of his experiences during the war and encouraging them to drop their agitation. 1967 to 1970, civil war was indeed an unpleasant experience, and as Obasanjo had stated in 2017, he doesn't want to witness another war. He couldn't be inspired to meet Kanu and other agitators across the country to quench the fire that may lead to another war.
Thanks for listening, and that is the news.